The only thing that I'm truly an authority on is my own personal religion. And I wanted to give some context to the arguments that I've made that religion is literally everything that people do, to why I think that and why I think that's an appropriate thing to think. So, like I said, I was raised in a group of people where religion was literally everything you do. And then I have studied perspectives on religion outside of that, which also still are literally everything you do. And so then when I'm qualifying my own personal religious identity as an individual, that's something that was important to me. I'm what some people call a quester, right? And so I want to quest towards my own unique take, although my take's not that unique, right? My take is it's everything I do. So how do I dress? Like, what kind of clothes do I have, and where, and why, and when, you know? That's, I have solved that question through religion. If you know me, know that I am religious about the clothing that I wear. Some people probably don't think that. Some people probably think that I'm just either an idiot, or I don't have any style, or that I am just too poor to buy anything new. But I like clothing that is utilitarian, that it can be worn to a wedding, it can be worn to work on a car. So I wear basically exclusively, you know, American-made, plain, everyman's clothes, right? Clear-cut, same color, blue, black, gray, brown, right? Simple as possible, no adornments, you know what I'm saying? All of these things. These are my robes. These are my, this is the monk outfit for my culture, as far as I'm concerned. I want to have the simplest, most permanent, cheapest, most, you know, it's universal. It can be worn to everything and anything. It, you know, if you don't, if you're not that active, it doesn't even have to be washed. You just have to change your drawers, man. I wear the same pants every day for months at a time, okay? And I do that to save water. I do that to fucking defeat any fucking trappings of fucking greed or, you know, materialism within myself that might come up. I do it for all kinds of reasons. I do it to make the world a better place by being a simpler person. Everything, like I'm saying, this, all of these, everything that informs my reasons for the way that I dress and have dressed for years and always will, always dress throughout my whole life, no matter what, right? No matter how far I go in the world, if I go anywhere, I'm still not going to change how I dress, because the way that I dress is religious for me, okay? It's my, it's, there are reasons why, they're deep, they're complex, there's lots of them. There's a whole Kabbalistic complex of reasons for why I dress the way I dress. My healthcare. Why my healthcare is the way it is. What do I do for healthcare? I use a permanent, everyday practice of body, spirit, mind, action, reality, intention. You know, I fuse all those things together in an everyday practice of Zen yoga. It's Zen and it's yoga. Zen, literally everything I do, yoga, literally everything I do, meditation, literally on all the time. I'm never not running an internal dialogue. I'm never not praying. I'm never not communicating with the all. There, I'm never faced with any point, even this video, this making of this, standing here against this wall with this camera right here. Even this moment is a religious moment for me. It's all a religious moment. I can't separate religion from who I am, because everything that I am doing has meaning. Everything that I am to me has meaning. Everything that I experience about this universe is important. It's significant. It has value. I love it. You know what I'm saying? Those are religious impulses. I want to lessen suffering. I have compassion for other things. That means that I have a reasonable limit for somebody who lives in my culture, because I don't want to be too holy, right? I don't want to be too holy. So my diet, for example, that's a question that people have to ask themselves. What am I eating? Why? What do I drink? Why? What do I eat? What do I drink? Why? You know what I'm saying? Who am I? What do I eat on a daily basis? Why? What do I drink on a daily basis? Why? Those are religious questions for me. Everything about that process is a religious process. It's all tied to my beliefs as a person. It's all tied to my feelings about the environment and the ecology and the political, business, social, environmental, the whole range of relationships that go behind that, right? What am I going to, you know, who do I spend my time with? That's a good question. What do I do with them? When I go and I think, when I hang out with the people that I hang out with, what do I do with them? What do I talk about? And what do I read about? And what do I, these are all religious to me. Everything about this is a religious thing. It's a religious question. It's a religious, it's my religion. It's who I am. Okay. Everything that I do with my life, the people that I love, my woman is my religion. My child is my religion. My family is my religion. You know what I'm saying? My relationships with my family of orientation and the severing of those relationships is part of my religion. You know what I'm saying? The plucking of my eye from the things in this world that I will not tolerate, which is violence, organized, systematized, authoritative, legitimized violence against entire groups of people in horrendous, horrible ways, literally making hell on earth a reality. This practice, I will not condone it. I will not look at it neutrally. I will not allow it to color my view. I pluck that from my eye. You understand what I'm saying? That decision is religious. My political context, everything that I am as a political person, when I vote, how I vote, if I vote, what I vote, all of my beliefs, my standpoints in terms of how I feel about social programs, how I feel about education, how I feel about human rights, how I feel about civil rights, everything that I have ever informed myself for this discourse and made an opinion about and been convicted and held on to that, if it has ever happened, has been a religious process. It's part of my religious tapestry. It's part of my religious cultural DNA. It's part of me. The religion inside of me that sews all of these things together informs and has a feedback loop with my politics. They are inseparable. I cannot separate them. It's impossible. See that? That's what I'm trying to say. Everything I do, the movies that I choose to watch, the websites I choose to view, the games I choose to play, the people I choose to associate with, the things that I choose to do for the world, all of this, all of it, all of it, all of it has to do with my meaningful interaction and interface with the universal and multiversal environment. It has to do with my understanding of the cosmological relationships at work in my life. It has to do with my understanding of myself, my body, what I put into it, what I put out of it, what all of it comes from where and everything else. It has to do with all of the art and the decorations in my home. Everything, every inch of my house is saturated in meaning and things that are not just there to be there. They are things that are there because they hold power. They have sacred monic power. They have monic power, mana power. They have sacred value to me. They have meaning and metaphor. They are friends. They are objects that I want in my life to help provide me with the environment that I choose to be part of, right? This whole thing, feng shui, every single part of my life is informed by this Zen study that I'm talking about, which anybody who studies Zen is going to sit there and say to themselves, man, this guy doesn't study Zen because his mind is all over the place. He's like a monkey mind. And the thing is that they don't understand in the midst of this fearing, whirling chaos that you see is a fucking soloist virtuoso plucking the fucking universal cord. Okay? That's what I'm trying to say, baby. No matter what you think, you can think whatever you want. But I'm telling you, my religion is me. My life, my way, my doing. I'm not trying to influence you. But I'm telling you one thing right now. I can't separate my religion from one single moment of my being. They go together. And they go together in terms of how I came into this world. They go together in terms of how I act in this world. They go together in terms of how I will go out of this world. And they all are linked, and they all are interwoven and intertwined and working together. And they all come to the center of the nexus of my soul, myself, my being, my experience. So take your ego teachings and, you know, stick them up your hoo-hoo, because I passed that bridge a long time ago, okay?